Sam and Katrina have so much chemistry and they really enjoy working together, and that really shows on the screen. But I think it was a fun challenge for us to see them for a change on two separate journeys.
We've spent almost 4 years together now working, and we were very fresh and green and a lot younger when we were cast. Yeah, I recently saw some of our auditions.
What's the matter? God, don't sulk, for God's sake.
Oh, sulk. Sulking, is it? I'm using all the self-control I've got to stop from shaking you until your ears rattle.
We were getting very close to first day of production. We didn't have a Claire. We had to have a Claire. We had looked for so long to find one.
Katrina just walked in. We just had lunch, and she walked in, and she looked magnificent, of course.
It's your own bloody fault. If you hadn't been ignoring me and suspecting me all the time, I told you the truth about who I am. And I told you there was no danger in me going with you. But would you listen to me? No, because I'm only a woman.
Neither of us were really aware of what was happening till afterwards. It just happened.
I think when you grabbed my hand, I like punched you in the face.
Oh, that was good.
Having good chemistry with your on-screen partner, because it just really brings it to life. I mean, Katrina and Sam do that. They've been doing it for the last 3 seasons, and they do it so well.
Sam's been doing my makeup, so we won't be on air until 2019.
We've had each other's backs. We've had each other's friendship and companionship. And so, you know, shooting this many episodes apart was, you know, there's definitely a different dynamic, a different energy on set.
It's strange in a way, because you do get used to having that day-to-day, you know, relationship where you see your friends. And Sam was doing a lot more scenes with newer characters. I was doing the Claire and Frank scenes that were so full of tension.
I want a divorce, Claire.
Usually there's a little bit more levity, but that wasn't the case necessarily in the beginning of our season this year.
We didn't really worry too much about keeping Claire and Jamie separated for that amount of time in the show. It just felt like the audience, you know, that was a good thing. Let the audience want them to get back together, build the hunger for the audience for their reunion.
For me, I wanted the audience to feel the same pain as Jamie and Claire, because if they don't, then it kind of cheapens the reunion.
Parting is sweet sorrow, and the more they stay apart, the more the joy when they get back together.
The first thing to bear that we had to sort of tackle was how long to keep Claire and Jamie apart, and what were the structure of those episodes going to be. We said, well, let's start with the Jamie storyline. And Jamie's story in the book is neatly divided into chapters. You know, the Culloden chapter, then he's living in the cave, then he goes to the prison, then he goes to Hellwater, and then he goes away and ends up at the print shop. So we put those chapters up on the board, and that kind of quickly told us that's 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, they'll get together after 5 episodes.
Every scene that Jamie is in without Claire, she's there somewhere. And the same goes with Claire.
We knew that we would find moments where, for instance, you know, whether it's a bird on a windowsill and Claire staring at this little bird, and you find out later she just felt it was him speaking to her.
We would never show Claire and Jamie in the same frame until they actually were reunited.
I found him.
In episode 5, we needed Claire to catch up, figure out Jamie was alive, that she could go back. And so it really progressed quite organically.
Pardon? I'm looking for a printer. Mr. Malcolm. Alexander Malcolm?
Should we give the audience a taste of them meeting a little earlier and then make the full reunion in 6? And that's what we did. So in a way, the fans got it 2 ways. They got it from Claire, and then they got it from Jamie.
We talked with the writers a lot about this idea that when you first see each other, it's almost like you are in this little bubble of fantasy.
It isn't Geordie.